Hi, my name is Andre Garcia. I'm a fourth year doctoral student from Miami, Florida. I'm currently working on a project under CENTEC, the Center of Excellence in Neuroergonomics, Technology, and Cognition. I've gone out to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base and worked for Air Force Research Lab for the last two summers. This summer, I particularly worked for the team called Batman, Battlefield Air Targeting Mandated Knowledge. So the particular project that I worked on was a haptics belt to help troops, to help dismounted soldiers navigate from point to point. It uses GPS technology to guide you from point A to point B while simultaneously alleviating and freeing up your visual channels so that you could search the environment for potential enemy threats and also free up your auditory instead of using 3D audio. Or in combination with the other modalities, giving you this redundant information lets you pick whichever channel or whichever modality of navigation aids you prefer to use. So this intelligent haptics belt is going to eventually be integrated into the dismounted soldiers' rucksacks, and it's created by Engineering Acoustics, Inc. in Orlando, Florida, and Castleberry, Florida. And it basically has eight tactors equally spaced around the waist, one on the navel, one on the spine, two on the sides, and the four in-between locations. And think of it as a pager or a cell phone on each of the eight locations. So if we want to direct you on where to go from point A to point B, we'll have a particular tactor activate and alert you on which direction to go to. So if it's the right side, we want to alert you and send you to my right, we'd have this tactor activate. But then when you turn around and square up to it, it'll be the center tactor that'll tell you where to go from a straight ahead shot. This is important because it helps free up the auditory and the visual channels. Current standards of navigation use 3D audio and or visual based forms of navigation, whether it's a forward up, egocentric kind of GPS, kind of off the shelf GPS on their small wearable computers, or whether it's even an old school paper map that uses a north up configuration. These require your attention and your resources to constantly look down at a map and so you could know where to go. But if we're guiding you using a haptics belt, then it frees up your auditory and your visual channels to scan the environment for potential enemy threats, particularly for our dismounted soldiers and the kind of forms of modern warfare that they're going through.